Welcome to Modular Classroom. In today's video, we will see an interesting feature that is available in MS Word, that is called Table of Contents. This feature allows the students' community, when they are dealing with their project documentation, and the research scholars when they are dealing with their thesis submission, and the authors who are writing book chapters, that is the persons who are dealing with the documents, it will be very helpful when they are writing a table of contents section of their document, whether it may be a project report or a thesis dissertation or a book chapters. If you are working in a long document, that is a document which consists of more than 1500 pages, and you need to insert a table of contents, this feature makes it easy to organize and navigate the document by inserting a neat automatic table of contents. That is, a table of contents, as you already know, it is like the chapter at the beginning of a book, and it lists each chapter in the document. Now, when you're processing the document, you have to create a first index is a page table of contents you have to create. So this MS Word, it allows an option called table of contents itself, so that it can be created manually, where you can type the each section or the chapter name and the page numbers. But it needs or it requires a huge amount of time. So that comes, and if you want to rearrange some paragraphs or something, and if the chapter wise is being rearranged, you have to add that information, you have to update it manually. But when you are applying right formatting and right style, this MS Word, it can create and update a table of contents automatically. That is, a table of contents is created automatically when you apply the right style for the formatting option that is available in document. So this table of content, mainly it is based on the headings in the document. If your heading style is proper and if it is formatted very neatly, it can automatically create the table of content in a very neat and legible manner. That is, if your heading style is applying to your document, it means that it is a new chapter or the new section of that particular document. So, when you're inserting the table of contents, it will create a section for each heading. So, main and foremost thing is you have to apply the heading style first. So, to apply a heading style, you just select the text to format and then choose the desired heading and styles group that is available on the home tab. After applying the heading style, you can easily insert the table of contents in just a few clicks. This is what we're going to see in today's video. We will see the demo, how come it works. See, this is one of the documents that exists in my local drive. Here I'm going to apply the table of contents here. So this is a chapter heading, and this is all the subheadings. 2.1 is a subheading, 2.2 is another subheading, and 2.3 is another subheading. This subheadings consist of subheadings also. See, this is 2.2 system, 2 is the system series, the chapter number. 2.1 is a subheading. This subheading contains another subheading also. First and foremost, in creating this table of contents, you have to apply the heading style properly. Now you will see how to apply. Just select this particular text and go to your home tab. Click on this heading 1, the styles tab. Choose this heading 1 option, since this is the first level. And next, this existing system you just choose and move to your heading 2. Just a minute, have to select with 2.1. Heading 2. And disadvantages of existing system is heading 3. Next, go to 2.2, propose the system. This is heading 2. And advantages of proposed system is a subheading under that, so heading 3. Next is feasibility study is heading 2. Economic feasibility is another inside it, so heading 3. Operational feasibility heading 3. Technical feasibility heading 3. So this is what you're going to apply your heading styles. Now after applying in just a few clicks, just go to this beginning, keep your cursor and click, go to your references tab, click on this references and choose this table of contents command. Click this table of contents. Now you can see built-in automatic table 1, automatic table 2, and the third option is table of contents that you're going to create manually. But this is a very tedious task since you have to type each and everything, including the section, chapter, heading, and the page numbers. But in automatic, you can just click any style if you want. You can just click contents. See how come neatly with just a few clicks you can able to get this table of contents. As you can see, two system studies are main heading. Subheading is 2.1 since I have erased this 2.1. And within that subheading, it includes another subheading disadvantage. And 2.2 is a proposed system. See how neatly this table of contents automatically with just a few clicks, including the chapter, heading, subheadings and the page number can be derived easily with using this table of contents option that is available under preferences tab. And another factor is if you want this to be, the whole document should be in the same font, it is also available. Select everything and give time any font to apply to the whole document, you can select. This is easy, and since this heading color is denoted to just notified, see I have cut this. Now I am including this 2.1, and after this 2.1, I can click on this table, and update table means it will ask and query, select which option. I am choosing update entire table and clicking OK. Now see, you can see this 2.1 change I have done here, it is also be reflected in my table of contents. Likewise, another important factor is this table of contents creates a link for each section allowing to navigate for different part of the document. See, if I want good technical feasibility to the page number 5, just I'm clicking Control plus click so that it takes me to the technical feasibility option. So no matter how large is my document, you can able to easily create the table of contents with this options available. But one of the first and foremost an important factor in this is applying the heading styles on the document to determine which chapter begins where and where to apply the heading level 2 or 3 so that it can be listed as a subheadings. So this is the method of creating the table of contents automatically. So thanks for watching. Stay tuned.